Welcome back, my dear student. So now that we have this working, our composer working, our emails being sent, we're using character sets here. We're using prepared statements. We got a lot of things going on. We have learned a lot in this couple lectures, right, guys? Right, I thought so. So now what we need is we need to send our code, okay, into our email with a link. So when people click it, they can go and be verified in our application, but we still don't have that page where we can send that. But let's actually, before we build a page, let's actually build a functionality. And then once we build a functionality, we can build that page, okay, to accept those values. So, and to build this functionality, this to put the links here is super easy. Let's actually write something here, and let's just say, please click to reset your password, something like that. And of course, what I want to do is, I don't want to put that in the H1. Gonna be PHP, and let's go and bring that all the way to the bottom. Let's actually create a link here. And let's just close, let's say click here. As a matter of fact, we're gonna include the whole link with the code in the anchor tag, just because some people don't have the ability to get links on their email, believe it or not. So we gotta have to go to, let's say you put the name of your website here. In our case, it's just the development server, right? Mine has a port of AAA, CMS. Yours could be just localhost, probably. And reset. .php is the page. Remember that we need a parameter for this to work. So we'll send the parameter later on, but right now just know that, actually let's just do the parameter now. This is going to take an email, okay, this parameter. I'm gonna cut this off right here and I'm gonna go like this. I'm gonna concatenate the email variable here, okay? And then when ampersand, I'm going to put another parameter there. Just come back here real quick. And it's going to be, I'm gonna concatenate the let's do this here real quick. And this will be talking here like this. Okay. That's it. I mean, so let's actually get the same thing in here like that. That looks good. Okay, we can test this. It's gonna go to a reset page we have not created yet. So let's actually test this and see if it works. The email there, it's okay. Okay, let's come back here. Okay, we got to take that off, but you can see here we have the link. When we click on it, we go to a page that does not exist, but the email is not working. As you can see, well, the email here looks like it's broken. Email parameters are not being passed after the email. So let's go back and see where we fail. So let's inspect this. Actually, here, that should be the problem there. Okay, we got this email. Let's come back here real quick. This looks good. My editor's not giving me any errors. Let's go back here. Let's just put this up here. There we go. It's trying to escape it automatically. We can, if we wanted to escape some of this code and just make it more readable. So email, we concatenate that. Then we concatenate this with a code. Okay, we break that here, finish that. We start with the other one, which is a string. Okay, that looks pretty good to me. Let's try it again now. Come back here. Oops, what happened? There we go. Well, that's working like this. We gotta fix that in a minute. At coding faculty. Oh, that's not gonna work like that, but I was able to get in that page. So we are able to get in this page here. We gotta fix that. I don't know why we keep oh, I see. Both of them right now. If it's not get or if it's and, if it's not, it has to be both of this for this to fail. That's why I had the or, right? Jesus, guys, I really. So if I make a mistake with one of these, this is not set. There we go. Let's go back here. And that's not set. We gotta come up with a better solution for this. So if the method is not set, the get method is not set, or this is not forgot, then we redirect. The problem is that when we click here, this refreshes and it doesn't have this field like this. Okay? So we gotta cancel that. Just gonna take one of these guys out for now. Later on, we come up with a better solution. I don't like this solution here because if these conditions, they don't meet. We can find a better one to do it, but right now let's just do it like this. It really, this functionality, it's something that we can work on later on, work out with the logic. I really don't want to mess around with this right now. We'll get something a lot better later on, okay? But right now let's just do it like that. That way we can play around with our stuff. Okay, so coding faculty, and let's just resend this. Okay, it was sent. Let's play around with this. And of course, for some reason, this site can't be reached, but you can see that the token is here and the email is there. Okay, so that's working. My server was down for some reason before. Nice working. Okay, so that's working. Our link is working. Now let's, on the next lecture, let's create the reset page and all the code that we need for that page. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next lectures.